The Formula Ford Festival, 3 days of intense competition. Senna and Prost seem a world away. Circuit, the Indy Circuit of Brands Hatch, is the arena where 200 drivers would battle through qualifying rounds and a final to discover the 1989 Duckhams Formula Ford Festival champion. Conditions bright but very windy as we join the first quarter final earlier with Mark Cole.
There in front of us is the Crossley of Fenton Parsons. Very distinctive rear end to that car with the streamlining. Now going up into the right-hander at McLaren. Critical corner, and my goodness, it's more critical than I thought because there's contact there. Oh my goodness, it's all over the place. Wreckage all over the place. Cars going through. Up goes Cole's arm, out of the race.
Not untypical Formula Ford racing, but Mark Cole and our camera out of action. The restarted race was over seven laps. Two-man duel between Michael Vergers in the blue Van Diemen on the left and the talented double junior champion David Coulthard, who takes the lead on the inside of Druids. That was on lap five, and he held on for a victory that guaranteed a front row position for the semi-final. Top 14, in fact, go through to the semis, but the leading six here include some men to watch, notably Ireland's Vivian Daly in third. Technology in Formula Ford racing includes some aerodynamics that McLaren might be keen to get hold of. Clean pair of heels in the second quarter-final. Well, that was shown by the favourite for the title, Nico Palhares of Brazil. But he only just was able to hold off the challenge of the Spaniard, Jordi Yanay. And the first six in the quarter-final really shows the international profile of the festival. Warren Hughes from Sunderland, the only British name among the leaders. Third quarter-final, Dave Coyne in a Swift leads the Reynard of Bernard Dolan, one of the best races of the qualifying competition, and a very heated battle out front. Coyne against Dolan, with a few others set to join in.
And now Dolan is again going for it as they go into paddock, and again Dave Coyne resists him. And off he goes. Now he will have lost time there, and that gives the opportunity to Neil Cunningham to move up into second place. Dolan goes down to fourth position because Rick Morris is coming up through the field, and he is now in third position. Watch the car in third position. This is one of the oldest men here today on the racetrack, 43-year-old Rick Morris, but his enthusiasm is undiminished, and neither is his ability any worse than it was. He's the lap record holder, and he goes up into second place. Rick Morris, who has been round Brands Hatch faster than anybody else at a speed of 90.01 miles an hour, he's really flying now, and so, for that matter, is Cunningham in second place. And look at this! Cunningham is up into second place. Rick Morris goes down into third position. And Bernard Dolan is in fourth place. And this is giving the leader, Dave Coyne, in the Swift. Most of the cars here today are Van Diemen side. There, out of the race, number 152 is Victor Lopez. He spun on the warm-up lap. And out also goes Frank Laforce, the Frenchman in the Orion. So this, their quarter-final is over. They won't be qualifying for the semi, but Dave Coyne is taking advantage of this tremendous scrap for second place to consolidate his lead. He is now coming through to complete lap five. with Cunningham second, Rick Morris in third place. Bernard Dolan, the fancied winner of the Formula Ford Festival, is not doing so well at the moment, but he's, as I say that, he goes through and takes Rick Morris in third position and attacks Neil Cunningham on the right-hander and Drew in second gear. Tremendous strap for third place. But of course, all this is working to the advantage of Dave Coyne. You can see he's extending his lead all the time. And Coyne is now, as he goes into the long right-hander at McLaren Clearways and Clark, he's 1.5 seconds ahead of the battle for third. Cunningham goes down to third position. And Bernard Dolan is up into second place. Rick Morris is third, Cunningham is fourth, and now Bernard Dolan has got the bit between his teeth. The gap between himself and Coyne is under a second, 0.8 seconds as they go into the right-hander and Druids, the slowest corner on the course on lap 6 out of 12. And Bernard Dolan has got the problem he had before. He will close up with Dave Coyne, swift of that I have no doubt. But, as I said earlier on, getting with Dave Coyne is one thing, getting past him is quite another. Because Coyne, with 5 years Formula Ford experience, he's been a past German, champion of Germany in Formula Ford 2000. He's driven sports cars, he's tremendously experienced. There is Rick Morris in the background in the yellow car in third position. Neil Cunningham in fourth place is dropping back. And now Dolan is going for it. This is the interest on lap 7. Swift car leads. And it is a Reynard in second place. And Dolan now goes through. Dolan takes the lead at Surtees on lap 7. And if this is not a very fast lap coming up, I will be very surprised indeed.
Indeed, it was a fast lap. Bernard Dolan setting a new lap record at 48.04 seconds, a speed of 90.22 miles an hour. The rest in his wake, including the former record holder, Rick Morris. So the third quarterfinal setting quite a competitive standard. Dave Coyne in second, Rick Morris was third. Last of the quarterfinals was won by this man, Scott Lakin. He had a more comfortable victory after an accident wiped out the challenge of Jonathan McGall and Gilda Ferran, although McGall recovered to take third. The quarterfinals, though, in a way, just jockeying for position. This is the serious stuff, the first of the semi-finals, and the run-in for the title that's been claimed in the past by the likes of Grand Prix drivers Johnny Herbert and Julian Bailey. And a very strong front couple of rows, led by the new lap record holder, Bernard Dolan.
But seconds to go now, the start is absolutely critical, and Bernard Dolan and Coulthard have both got excellent starts, and Coulthard right alongside Dolan, but Coyne trying to go through on the inside and failing, and as they go up Aylward Rise for the first time into Druids Hill Bend in this 15 lap race, because it's a semi-final. Dave Coyne seemed to be dropping back a bit, but first, second, third, yes, sure enough, and in the lead it is Bernard Dolan. David Coulthard right behind his gearbox. Dave Coyne just a whisker further back in third position. So it is a Reynard leading, a Van Diemen second, a Swift in third place. And in fourth position it's Rick Morris, the veteran ex-lap record holder, because his lap record has been beaten by the man who's leading, Coulthard. One lap completed. Coulthard is in second place, and it's Dolan, the new lap record holder. Just look at Dolan defending his lead, and that gives Coyne the opportunity to close up. Coyne is going to be on the inside. No, he's not, as Coulthard comes down to the left-hander at Graham Hill Bend. This incredibly mature 18-year-old driver who has already this year won both the Formula Ford Junior Championships holds his second place behind the RAC Formula Ford champion of 1989, Bernard Dolan, coming through now to complete their second lap. Now look at the gap between Dolan and this battle for second position. as Coyne once again has a look round the left-hand side of David Coulthard's Van Diemen. It's still the Reynard leading, Van Diemen second, Swift third. And Coyne is doing everything he can to hassle and worry and agitate David Coulthard. But as I said before, this young Scotsman manages to keep incredibly cool and under pressure, holding his second place. There's just two laps to go at the end of this one. This long, this corner is so long, it's got three names. It starts as McLaren, goes into clearways, exits as Clark. Dolan is now on his 14th and last lap but one. And number one, who you can see has just spun out there, Brian Anderson from Liverpool in the Van Diemen. Coyne sawing, weaving, dodging, ducking, turning all the time. But David Coulthard does what he should do. He stays on the racing line. And if you go round the racing line as fast as you possibly can, and you are of equal ability to the man behind you, there is no way he can get past you, short of ramming you, and David Coyne will not do that, I hope. Over the line now to start his last lap, Bernard Dolan. There's the brilliant Irishman. He's built an enormous gap now, and Dave Coyne now knows that it's the last lap. He knows that if he's going to finish in second place and preserve a chance to be on the front row of the grid, now's the time to do it. David Coulthard knows exactly the same thing. And number 51, David Coulthard, has won 22 Formula Ford races this year, but those were in the Junior Championships, the P&O Junior Championship, the Star of Tomorrow Junior Championship. He won his quarter final. That's a senior race, and very much so, in this great Ford Festival. And over the line now, Bernard Dolan wins the first semi-final with the last lap of 48.84. And Coyne is going for it, but he just fails by half a car's length to take second position from David Coulthard. Dave Coyne in third position then. Michael Berger's in fourth position. In fifth place, it was Alan McGarrity. And in sixth place, the Australian Neil Cunningham. As the contestants for the second semi-final line up, there has been a little rain and there is a touch of slimy dampness on the circuit surface. And because of that, in pole position, Nico Palares, the Brazilian, is having adjustments made to the roll bar of his car just to soften up the suspension a little. And a highly meritorious second on the grid is Scott Lakin, 19 years old, from Ashby, driving a Reynard. Second in his heat, first in his quarter-final, with a clear track in front of him to Paddock Bend. And on the second row of the grid, it's Jordi Yene, the Spanish driver, and David Button in the blue car, second rank on the right. 15 laps to go. Palares must get a good start to maintain his unbroken winning record. And he doesn't. Scott Lakin gets an absolute cracker. And what is more, Palares is edged out of second place as they end third position. No, he's regained it as he goes. No, he hasn't run very wide indeed. There's an attack coming up from Palares, and Palares, my goodness, look at that as they go into the right-hander. It is still 19-year-old Scott Lakin in the lead. Palares is down into fourth position, and that is very bad news indeed for the Brazilian. But it's Jonathan McGall in second position. And there is Palares, the hot favourite for this second semi-final, down in third position, and he is attacking Jordi Yene, the Spanish driver in the Van Diemen, the man who won his heat, fastest lap, second in the quarter-final, 15-lap race over the line. Scott Leakin, this is totally unexpected and a tremendous achievement, because he's now going to be able to pull away from this terrific battle for second place. It's Alan McGall now in second place, and Jordi Yene in third position. No, he's dropping back into fourth. That's in the red and white car. McGall is up. Palares is up into third position. So that's one place gained for the Brazilian. He has now got to attack and try to get McGall, who is in second place, and Scott Leakin. There is Alan McGall, number one, Jonathan McGall, I'm sorry. 187, 22 years old, won his heat. And you can see how close it is behind him. Tremendously strong competition. Now, Leakin has got a problem. Palares is attacking McGall. Jonathan McGall is in second place, sandwiched between Nico Palares and Scott Leakin. And McGall attacks, going off on the inside. He will surely get through. But Scott Leakin squeezes the door shut. Palares drifts around on the outside, onto the grass almost. Loses a place in the process. We are on lap three in this second semi-final. And now it is Jordi Yene who is attacking. There are one, two, three, four, five cars virtually together. Jonathan McGall in second place. Scott Leakin, the 19-year-old leader, driving an absolutely immaculate race. There is a 10-second penalty there for Patrick Le Marie, the French driver, second in the championship, and that will be for jumping the start. McGall attacks, attacks, attacks. The race leader, Scott Leakin, in the orange and white car, number 177, and he goes for it, and McGall is going through and takes the lead brilliantly as he goes up into Druids on lap 4 out of 15, and out of the race goes Frank Bradley. Now they're coming down. Let's see how the lap times compare with the new lap record as Scott Leakin attacks again, trying to go through on the inside. Jonathan McGall staving him off, drifting very wide, goes off wide indeed on the run-up to Druids Hill Bend, and still Scott Leakin holds on. This is an absolutely inspired drive by the young Englishman from Aspy de la Zouche, sixth in the Star of Tomorrow Championship in 1989. And Scott Leakin is actually in Formula Ford as a result of winning a competition last year, which gave him a course at a racing driver's school. There were 400 entries. Scott Leakin won, and my goodness, he's making the most of it now. Second in the second semi-final as the leader, Jonathan McGall, crosses the line. Leakin attacks again. 49.77 seconds. And look at that. Polaris now is pulling away from Jordi Yene. And that's it. He nearly lost the car. And hit. That was Scott Leakin. Getting just a touch wild there. Above all things in Formula Ford, as in most forms of motorsport, you have to keep cool and you have to drive a steady, smooth race. If you lose any power on these cars through going wide, you've got the knowledge that everybody else has got the same power as you. 100 brake horsepower. If you've got a Formula Ford engine that will give you more than that, you are doing very well indeed. Coming through to complete lap 9. One, two, three, four cars together. They have broken away now. No, one. Hughes is closing up. Number 91, Hughes is up, and there goes Scott Leakin. That's Scott Leakin spinning out. That was unsurprising. Now he's got to wait for the rest to get through. While he spins his car, let's hope nobody hits him as they come out of paddock bed. Well, he's lost a lot of places now. And now there is a gap. Jonathan McGall has got Jordi Yene behind him in second place. Up into third place has come Hughes. Number 91, Warren Hughes. There he is, the man from Sunderland, 21 years old, an instructor at the Jim Russell Racing Driver's School. And we can have a look at that again. Now, here they are. Now, look at Scott Leakin, number 177, the orange and white car. He touches wheels with Palares, who drifts out very wide onto the old part of the circuit, manages to keep going. Scott Leakin, with that mega bump at the back, does not. Spins out, and effectively his race is lost. So now we are on lap 11 in this 15-lap race, and as you can see, it is Jonathan McGall and the time lead that he has over Jordi Yané, the Spanish driver, number 30 in the background, is 2/5 of a second. That's how close it is. But you've seen that it's slippery. Colares, number 95 in the yellow and blue car, the Brazilian, is the Esso champion of 1989, one of the two major championships in British Formula Ford racing. But Jordi Yané, number 30, and that out of the race there, number 137, is Victor O'Ferrill. And it may surprise you with a name like that, he's actually a Mexican. And Polaris is through up into second place. Now he has got to catch Jonathan McGall. This is lap 12. There are three laps to go at the end of this one. And Nico Polaris, to maintain his unblemished winning record here at Brands Hatch today, has got to get ahead of Jonathan McGall, and he's closing up on him all the time. Third in the RAC Championship this year, Nico Polaris. Jordi Yané is attacking again. He comes out from behind Polaris' gearbox as they go over the line, absolutely together. But Polaris has got the inside line of paddock, and he will stay where he is, that is to say, in second place. But because Polaris has got this problem of Yané, that means that Jonathan McGall is having a much more relaxed drive than he would have if Polaris could attack him single-mindedly without worrying about Yané in the background. And now Jonathan McGall is coming up to lap at tail-ender. This is always a dangerous situation for a leader. This is lap 13 out of 15, second semi-final. And McGall is battling, oh my goodness, off there, number 87 off at Druids, Fionn Murray, the Irish Formula 4 double champion of 1989. McGall goes over the line, and Polaris is closing up. Now McGall has got this lapping problem, he's taken him, and Polaris knows that he's just got this lap and the next one to get past Jonathan McGall. Polaris is driving a Van Diemen, and Jonathan McGall is driving a Mondial. That's an Irish car. Not many of them. And they haven't done well in the Formula Ford Festival in the past against the Van Diemens, of which there are many more, of course. Ralph Furman's car made up in the East Anglia. Scott Lakin is in 11th place. The man who spun off in second place has battled his way through into 11th. And now Jonathan McGall goes across the line shortly to start his 15th and last lap. And the lap times are down to some 50 seconds because of the dampness, compared with the new lap record of Bernard Dolan, 48.04, 90.22 miles an hour. So McGall leads, Polaris in second place, Jordi Yané in third position, in fourth place it is Warren Hughes, and just for the record, it's Pekka Erma, the Finnish driver, in fifth position, and Kreutz Pointner, the German, in sixth position. So there's quite a spread of nationalities. Germany, Finland, Ireland, Brazil. And you're looking now at Jonathan McGall sweeping victoriously out of Clark Curve for the last time in this semi-final to win very convincingly at the end from Nico Polaris, Jordi Yané, Warren Hughes, a long gap before the fifth and sixth come through. It's Pekka Erma in fifth position and Kreutz Pointner in sixth place. Pole position for the most important race of his life. Bernard Dolan from Dublin. He has won his heat. He's won his quarter final. He broke the lap record. He then won the semi-final. He went out and broke the lap record again. 90.37 miles an hour, and he is ready to go to win the Formula Ford Festival. Jonathan McGall from Belfast, driving an Irish Mondial. He won his heat, he won his first semi-final. He's had a poor year for him, fourth in the Formula Ford Festival of 1988. Can he go better this year?
As you can see, for this vital final, the weather conditions are diabolical. Rain is falling. The surface of the circuit is very wet. They are on the fullest depth tyres they could possibly get. Row three of the grid, Englishman Dave Coyne, Spaniard Jordi Yanchenet. Row four, Michael Vergers and Warren Hughes. And away they go. And Bernard Dolan is left very badly indeed. And he's about 12th when he goes into the first corner. And leading away into the first corner, it's McGall, Jonathan McGall, the man who won the second semi-final. And there's a spinner in the middle there. It looked like Neil Cunningham, but he's missed absolutely everybody. That was quite incredible. And it was there. Number 53 is Michael Vergers, one of the fancied men, because he went second fastest in his quarter-final. But Jonathan McGall is the man, and Nico Pallares, the man who was fancied all the way through, first in his heat, first in his quarter-final, but only second in his semi-final, and he threw! Mike, that's Dave Coyne! Dave Coyne goes straight past Nico Pallares, but runs very wide on the corner. This is a 20-lap race, and you can see that Bernard Dolan has slipped right down the field, and now across the line goes Jonathan McGall. It's Pallares second. David Coulthard is right with Dave Coyne. Dave Coyne goes into second place at Paddock Bend, but Pallares is driving around the outside of him, and the incredible young David Coulthard, number 51 on the left, is in fourth position, while Nico Pallares dodges and weaves and slips and slides around the right-hander at Druids. But it is still Jonathan McGall, the 22-year-old Irishman, and out of the race there. 176 is Fran Riley, the Irish driver. His Formula Ford Festival is over, but it's very much on for this lot, and this lot leads Jonathan McGall, leading from Ireland. Nico Pallares in the striped car, the Van Diemen, is in second place. Jonathan McGall is driving a Mondial, and a Mondial, the Irish car, has never won this vital race. It may do so today, but not if Nico Pallares can stop him. Meantime, Dave Coyne is in third position. David Coulthard is in fourth place. Jordi Genet, the Spaniard, is in fifth place. And in sixth position, it's Bernard Dolan. Bernard Dolan has come up into sixth place. Now count them off at Druids. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The blue car, that's Bernard Dolan. The lap, there he is, Bernard Dolan. He has broken the lap record once this afternoon. He went out and broke the lap record again. He's the only man with a totally unblemished record, having won his heat, his quarter-final, his semi-final, and broke the lap record twice. And he's now, as you can see, chasing Jordi Genet, the Spaniard, number 30, who is driving absolutely perfectly at the present moment. He's in a Van Diemen. There we are. There's yet another one out. That's Alan McGarrity from Belfast. And here is the battle out of the circuit to complete lap three. And Pallares is going for it now. He's decided very much to attack, to try and get out of the slipstream and the water that's being thrown at him. And he's thrown, he spins! Out he goes, Pallares goes out, and out goes Jonathan. Jonathan McGall is out of the race, and now Dave Coyne leads. Coulthard is second. Jordi Genet is in third position, and they come out of Druids Hill Bend. Now the enormously experienced and determined Dave Coyne in the English Swift, Frank Bradley's car, and there is the unfortunate Jonathan McGall, who had every hope of winning the festival. Here's what happened. Jonathan McGall on the inside, Nico Pallares on the outside. Now watch Pallares, he cuts in, and zap! Straight into the left front wheel of McGall's car. Pallares spins, McGall with his left front wheel hanging off goes out of the race, and now it is a tremendous scrap as they're coming across the line, and Coulthard is in second place. This brilliant 18-year-old Scotsman in second place behind Dave Coyne on lap five, one quarter distance of this 20-lap race. And look at the battle behind.
Polaris is in fourth position. He's up into third position now. He's passing Jordi Genet, the Spaniard. Nico Polaris, Jordi Genet fights out back, and he's going to have the inside line round Graham Hill Bend. And he takes that third position back from Polaris. So it's a Brazilian in fourth place, a Spaniard in third place, a Scotsman in second place, and an Englishman leading the Formula Ford Festival. What a scrap. What an incredible drive already, too, by David Coulthard. I've said before, and I'll say again, we're going to hear a great deal more from this young man. This is his first year of single-seater racing. He has won both the Junior Formula 4 Championships of Britain, and he's now attacking Dave Coyne. And Dave Coyne, of course, is the toughest, hardest, most experienced man on the circuit, and Dave Coulthard is going to learn a lot from Dave Coyne in this race. And of course, if a Swift wins, it would be the first time that this car had won the festival, and it would be an enormous fillip to Frank Bradley's firm's sales prospects, because sales of Formula Ford cars take their time from the winner of the festival. And at the moment, it's Dave Coyne leading. Number 122 then, 32 years old, ex-German Formula Ford 2000 champion. Fourth in the RAC Championship this year, second in the SO Championship, 5 years of Formula 4 driving. And he's getting his revenge at the... Or is he? You can see how difficult it is to control the cars in these circumstances. There's more than a film of water on the surface. They're putting down 100 horsepower through those comparatively narrow tyres. And Coyne has extended his lead a little. On lap 7 out of 20, Coyne leads, Coulthard second, Polaris in third position, Jordi Genet in fifth position. And coming up through the field in fifth place, I'm just checking, it's Fernandez, the Spanish driver in the blue car. Look for sixth position, there he goes. And there, number 157. Is Bernard Dolan. We've forgotten him for the moment. He's got his time cut out now, because it's not just that he's in fifth position. He's got those four cars in front of him throwing up great curtains of spray into his eyes, obscuring his vision. He's now closing up on Jordi Genet, number 157, Bernard Dolan, the lap record holder now of Brands Hatch Indy Circuit for Formula Ford, in the time of 47 seconds, 0.96, 90.3 miles an hour. Coyne leads, Coulthard second, Polaris third. Swift lead off, go. Well, out of the race there, that's John Molum. Look at this. Three, four, five cars at Polaris. It goes through into second place. Well, a lot of people have tipped Polaris to win this race. Now, how is he going to cope with Dave Coyne? It would crown Dave Coyne's Formula Ford experience. After 5 years of it, if he won the festival, he's been so close to doing it in the past, but never quite succeeded. And Dave Coyne, for that matter, has not had the breaks in motor racing that he might have had. It would be a wonderful finish to, I imagine, his Formula 4 career if he won here. But Nico Polaris, 23 years old, is going for it, and Coulthard is fighting back. You can see that Coulthard, number 51, in the middle, in the Van Diemen, with a Swift leading, a Van Diemen second, a Van Diemen in third position, and this is Polaris' chance. He can get through on the inside, and he's done it! He's done it! He's forced Dave Coyne out wide, and the Englishman will not be able to get round there. Polaris drifts his car out to the left, eases Coyne out, up into second position goes Coulthard, down to third place goes Dave Coyne. And now we are on lap 9 in this 20-lap race. There's a lot of it still to go. Now, there's a back marker. How is Polaris going to cope with him? It's John Molum. Because Genet, now Genet, Dave Coyne's got a major problem too, and that is to keep this fighting Spaniard back, who's going through on the inside. Genet goes through on the inside. Coyne cuts through, takes a tighter line. They're coming out of Clark Curve. Genet cuts across. You'll notice he's got his rear light on. And all the time, of course, this is helping Nico Polaris and David Coulthard, because Coyne and Genet are getting in each other's way. Neither of them can take the ideal racing line. Coyne goes back into third position on lap 13 out of 20. And now the Dutchman is coming up through the field. Michael Vergers, you will notice, is coming up fast in the background. He is in fourth position behind Genet, fifth position behind Genet, who is fourth in the white car. Here is the leader, Pallares. Coulthard in second place, in line abreast. Coyne, Genet. And Vergers goes through. With a brilliant bit of opportunistic driving, Michael Vergers, number 53 in the John Village Van Diemen, the man from Alkmaar, and now he's up past Easter. This is definitely the man to watch, Michael Vergers. Now, let's see what the gap is between David Coulthard in second place and Michael Vergers with a clear run, 1.8 seconds. That's the car to watch. The Van Diemen of Michael Vergers. Sixth in the RAC Championship this year, and funnily enough, he is the ex-kart champion, not of Holland, but of Spain. And he drove in the festival final last year. He's having to protect the position he's just gained from Dave Coyne, who's dropping back. Coyne, who led in the Swift, is now in fourth position. And off at paddock there, number 105, is the Mexican Adrian Fernandez. Well, two laps to go after this one. Pallares is approaching the line. The boards will go out, and in particular, Vergers, chasing the brilliant David Coulthard, will see his opportunity. I think not so much to win, but certainly to take second position. And speaking from memory, I don't think a junior Formula 4 driver has ever been as high up in the final as David Coulthard is, irrespective of whether he's second or third, and very soon he might be third, because look at the way Vergers going. They touch wheels coming out of Druids, down into Graham Hill Bend at over 100 miles an hour on the Cooper Strait, even in this weather. And now Coulthard, I say again, at 18 years old, has got an incredibly old and mature head on his young shoulders, but now Vergers has got him and goes through the interlock wheels, but Coulthard, with a brilliant bit of driving, just untwists his front wheels and gets them away from Vergers, who has now got the last lap only to close up on Nico Pallares. But Coulthard is fighting back for that second position. Jordi Genet in the background is still in fourth place. It is a Brazilian leading. It is a Dutchman second. It is a Scotsman in third place. And Coulthard is going for it at Druids. He won't get round on the outside, but he's trying jolly hard. He's trying a bit too hard because he drifts wide. And that's lost him a lot of vital time and space. But what a drive. But it's going to be Pallares, first in his heat, first in his quarter-final, the Esso champion, ex-car champion, 11 Formula 4 wins of 1989. But this is going to be the most important one of his life. He is now out of McLaren, and my goodness, Vergers is right up with him. That is incredible. Vergers can still do it. Not now, he can't. Pallares has got him, but it's going to be a desperately close thing over the line. Pallares wins the Formula Ford Festival of 1989 with a brilliant drive, and you can see how overjoyed he is, but he only just did it because Michael Vergers was right up with him, and an equally meritorious third position goes to that brilliant young Scotsman on the right, number 51, David Coulthard, within the background in fourth place, Spaniard Jordi Genet, a truly international Formula Ford Festival.